Just want to talk about three things. I'm going to pray three things that will definitely turn things around for you. If you're looking for a breakthrough in any area of your life, three things that I have experienced recently that have really turned my life completely around. We're just going to have a word of prayer. We're just going to share this with you. Father, we thank you for the word of God. The word is life to them that find it. The inches of your word give it light. And we thank you, God, for the revelation of your will. And Father, we thank you for the Spirit of God that is working mightily in us. And we thank you, Father, that you effectually worketh in them that believe. We believe, Father, we stand on your promises, and all of your promises are yea and amen. There hasn't failed one word of all of your promises. Your promises are sure to every seed and to every generation. We give you praise. We give you the glory in Jesus' name. Everybody just say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 Want to put this out there that one of the most important things that you will reap great benefits. I'm just going to read that scripture to you. This is going to be Hebrews 13, 17. I just want you to turn there. This scripture is, obey them that have the rule over you and submit yourselves, for they watch for your souls, as they that must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that is unprofitable for you. That scripture stood out this week. Obey them that have rule over you and submit yourselves, for they watch for your souls, as they must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that is unprofitable for you. Now, when I read that this week, it was a real spirit of fear. Not scary fear, but a respect and reverence for God that really began to weigh heavily on me, because to a certain degree, I am responsible for those that I have authority over. And God will hold me accountable for those that I have watch over if I don't do it with reverence, with faith, and all of the other things that's important for the growth of a ministry. And I want to do everything that I can. You know, a lot of the work of pastor is warning, and nobody want to focus on the area of ministry that deals with warning. Scripture says warning comes before what? Destruction. And I think that the way things are going in our country, I think it's a good thing for people really to begin to get their mind on eternal things and not so much on things on this earth. Seek ye first, seek ye things above and not things on the earth. Because I believe that the destiny of America resides in the hands of believers to a great extent. And I think that there is something that believers gotta do in order for this country to complete, to survive, amen, especially the next 4 years, or maybe the next 8 years, if there be another 8 years. So I wanted to just encourage you to put all emphasis in the scripture that I'm going to read today, one of the most important factors that will determine your destiny is going to be found in the first scripture that I'm going to give you. And that's the reason why I'm always consistently admonishing you, warning you to focus on the Word, put the Word first place in your life. When it comes to lessons, when it comes to attending classes and being involved in teachings, that's going to be very important for you to survive in order for you to be in a place where you will be counted worthy to escape the things that are coming upon the earth. Amen. So knowledge is a whole big issue. It's good. The Bible says that God's people are destroyed because of the lack of what? Knowledge. Amen. And I think that knowledge, the Bible says righteousness can deliver us from death. And the scripture says that the work of righteousness shall be peace. Everybody just say that with me. The work of righteousness shall be peace. And the effects of it, quietness and assurance forever. Better saying a whole lot, quietness and assurance. God said he will keep us in perfect peace when our minds are what? Stayed on him, because we trust in him. So quietness and assurance is a big thing. Quietness and assurance forever. Bible even mentions about boldness in the day of judgment when we do God's word and carry out God's will for our lives. Boldness in the day of judgment. And the Bible says that when Jesus comes, it's the love that we have for others and the love that we have for God that determines the confidence that we will have at his appearance. The Bible says that though that walk in love, it will assure our hearts and we won't be ashamed at his appearing. Amen. So I just want to get the word out there because I feel that everybody is responsible for responding to the word that we are teaching. Everybody is responsible because we hear it. Amen. And I don't think that we can get it all alone. No man is an island and no man can stand alone. 1 Timothy 4, verse 12, this is speaking about the first thing I want to mention today, three things that are essential for your spiritual breakthrough. Let no man despise thy youth, even your old age, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation. The word conversation there is your lifestyle. In charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. All of those things mentioned there are things that we are asked or admonished to be an example of. In word, in your lifestyle, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. Now, here are the things that the writer admonishes us to do. Till I come, give attendance to reading. Amen. Some say, well, I don't like to read. Well, the Bible says that give attendance to it. Amen. It was a gentleman that was here years ago that was physically abused by his parents. I think I mentioned this recently. And he grew up as a child that was severely neglected. In fact, he was a castaway, ran away from home at 5 years old. And he was, his parents tried to destroy him by putting him in an oven. This man stood right up here. And he grew up outside of the church, and he became a drug addict. He became a homosexual, and he just lived a really perverse life. But at 19, he got saved, and he got filled with the Holy Spirit, and he couldn't read at that stage. He couldn't read. He never learned how to read because of all of the abuse. And what happened was that when he got saved, he began to listen to the Word of God. And he did it 8 hours a day. And after so many weeks and months transpired, he was able, God began to quicken his understanding. His mind was anointed, and the Word really began to come through in the area of his intellect, and he began to learn how to perceive. In fact, he began to remember the Bible. He could remember Bible by the chapters. I mean, he was able to retain it through his commitment to the Word of God. And he, at that point that he came to minister, he had become a millionaire. And he attributes all of this to his commitment. Although he couldn't read the Word, he had the ability to listen to the Word. And he began to memorize it. He began to register and stick with his mind. And that was the thing. The Bible says the entrance of his Word giveth what? Light. Giveth understanding to the simple. So we don't have too much excuse. Because if we find a way, if we have to listen to it, we have to read it, read it from, DVDs have the Bible, right? CDs have Bible. And I tell you that when you come to Northside Christian Center, you get a whole lot of ways to get the Word if you don't like to read. Amen. So we just want you to understand that the meditations that we are recommending you do, that's very important, because meditation is the way that God gets into our what? Hearts, and the Word becomes alive to our spirits. Amen. So I want you to look at that. Till I come, give attendance to read into exhortation. And exhortation is admonishing others. This is the reason why every person that possibly can need to be in Bible study. If you can't be in Bible study, I'm willing to meet you wherever I can meet you. In other words, I will do it at church. I will do it at your home. I can send somebody to your place of business or wherever we need to. And where there's a will, there's a way. How many can say amen? So I don't recommend you being a part of this ministry and not making yourselves available to the Word of God that we are teaching from these manuals, because you will be held accountable for it. You can't do it all alone. You need help. Amen. How many can say amen? Then the other thing, exhortation. And I think that we have one of the best ways to share the Word with each other that possibly can be found today is through meditation books. And we were in a class the other day, and the person that we were ministering Bible lesson to, she was desirous of somebody that would call her and just read some of the exhortations in the area of healing. So we have tremendous opportunities, and I believe that, you know, I call people, I read the Bible on the phone to them. I do Bible lessons, I read the Word from the phone. And if you're really concerned about your sister, your brother, or walking in love, the Bible mentions that how dwelleth the love of God in us when we see our brother in need and shutteth up our bowels of compassion. from them how dwelleth the love of God. Now, I believe that the scripture says, don't withhold no good thing from them to whom it is due, right? Amen. We owe no man anything, nothing but what? To love. It's the only thing that we owe, the debt of what? Love. Amen. So it's our responsibility is to strengthen our, amen, our sisters and brothers. Amen. We need motivation. We need help. You know, when somebody called me and just encouraged me, it helps me. Amen. How rarely do you ever have anybody that will listen to you from week to week, month to month, year to year? That ever will come to you, so Pastor Hill, I appreciate the meditation book. I appreciate the word. I appreciate the prayer. I know that in prayer means we don't play. We pray. Amen. It's hard to find somebody that will encourage you. Amen. You know, I guess everybody's wrapped up in their own lives. You know, if we're wrapped up in ourselves, we make a very, very small package. If we're wrapped up in ourselves. But we have to be concerned about what others. So this is one of the greatest ways that God has provided for us to really to be perfected in love. We can't be perfected in love staying in our own corners. People got to perfect you. Adversity got to perfect you, right? Amen. Bible says, how can we say we love God whom we have never seen and you don't have anything to do with your sister or brother that you see every day? I think the greatest blessing that you have at your disposal that can bring God's promises to pass in your life is to love, is to reach out and to help. Amen. Amen. So that has been probably the strongest factor in my life as a believer, period. I have always loved to share with people the word of God. I believe that, how many believe that work, love working no ill to this neighbor? Amen. So I want you to understand what it requires in order for God's promises to be manifested. How many want God's blessings released in your life in some area? Probably in the area of, how many are looking for a husband or wife? You don't have too many. We had last night at the marriage class, we had the hope. Some of them, I wondered, you know, I mean, they passed that 7-0 mark. Well, around approaching there, I guess. But they were sitting up in a marriage class. Amen. Well, the Bible says he that findeth a what? A wife findeth a what? A good thing. So you might can find somebody out there, a good thing, over 60 or 70. Amen. But I was in there. I'm not looking for no wife. I have one. But I want to know how to make my marriage what? Better. Not only make my marriage better, but I want to be able to counsel others that want to make their marriage better. And I wouldn't get that information if I weren't attending. Anybody with me? I've attended the class every time they've had it. I've been here every time they've had it. Amen. And I still feel a need to what? To continue to come until I can perfect, amen, my knowledge in that particular area of ministry. And I think it's a very important ministry. And I think that many of us would do good. If we are interested in people, I think that you would avail yourselves to whatever you can that can enrich the lives of others. Amen. I think that we ought to be concerned about others. It's the key. Amen. The Bible says if we want a good establishment in holiness, we're going to have to what? Increase more and more in love. That's the thing that what makes you perfect. That's the thing that the Bible says, perfect love casteth out what? Fear. Hallelujah. So the more you love, let me just share this with you. I'm still going to come back to that scripture, James 3. This is a scripture that shows love perfected, those that have walked the love walk for a while and have perfected it, what they are like. Amen. This is an awesome scripture, James 3:16-17. It says here, but the wisdom, see, wisdom is love perfected. Once you walk in love, once you carry out the will of God for those within and those without the kingdom of God, doing all that you can to be a blessing to them. And there's a wide range of activities that God has instructed us to do in terms of reaching out to those without and those within. And I think the least you could do, amen, is to call somebody on the phone and share the gospel or share meditations. You know, if both of you are sick, mostly everybody, you know, got some type of physical complaint, the greatest thing that you could possibly do to encourage or help somebody is to share scriptures that's focusing on what? Meditation, on healing in the area of meditation. Amen. Nothing can build faith. Nothing can give you hope beyond despair. Nothing can change your circumstance. Nothing can get you established in faith. Amen. More than what? Confessing or declaring the word of God that deals with what? God's promises and provisions for our healing. It's a need everybody have. Amen. If you want to get your prayers answered, you're going to have to help somebody else to what? To get their needs met. That's the way it works. Amen. Faith works by what? Love. Amen. Scripture says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall what? Amen. They shall obtain what? Mercy. Bible says, confess your faults, what? One to another. And pray one for another that ye might be what? Healed. So our healing is definitely tied up in our love and our concern for our sisters and brothers. Some say, well, I can't minister to them. I'm sick. That's the reason why you do need to minister to them. You need to release some of that what? That nervous energy. Amen. Get some joy going. Get some words in your mouth that will work for you. And I found out that very few people are going to do meditation. You know, the Bible says in his law, doth he meditate day and night? Is that right? Am I quoting that right? Day and night. He recites the word of God to himself day and night. That's what the godly man will do. Joshua 1 says that don't let the word of God depart out of your mouth, but thou shalt what? Meditate day and night. And all of these has great promises. And the amen, though Psalms 1 says, and they shall be like a what? Tree planted by the rivers of waters that bring forth their fruit in this season. Their leaf shall not what? Wither, and whatsoever they do it, it shall. How many want to prosper? Amen, amen. Lift your hands and say, I want to prosper. But the Bible says, if you want to prosper, the word of God shall not depart out of your mouth, but thou shalt what? Meditate it day and night. And then thou shalt what? Make your way what? Prosperous, and you will have, how many want to have good success? Touch somebody and say, I want to be healed. God promises you healing, but he's not going to, amen, manifest his love and amen, his works in our life if we just sit there and don't do anything. Faith comes by what? Hearing. And hearing by what? The word of God. But the scripture says we got to be doers of the word. Is that right? Amen. Let me tell you, those that are not concerned about others, I'm going to show you somebody that's not going to be blessed God's way. You might be blessed the world's way. We call that pseudo-prosperity. But the Bible says the blessings of the Lord maketh what? Rich. Not just with money in the bank. Amen. I tell you,
The greatest riches you could ever have is what? The assurance. The Bible says, righteousness, amen. The work of righteousness shall be what? Peace. How many believe that peace is riches?
Yes, yes,
yes. Everybody don't have peace. God said he'll keep them in perfect peace when their minds are what stayed on him. The work of righteousness, everybody say the work of righteousness, shall be peace. And the effects of it, quietness and assurance. I don't think nobody got as much quietness and assurance as I got, because I got a good family. Beautiful wife, a loving wife, smart wife. She tried to boss me sometimes. But sometimes I need bossing, right? Probably need a spanking too, huh? Quietness and assurance. Work of righteousness shall be what? Peace. And the effects of it, what? Quietness and assurance. But remember, when we first started out as a couple, we started out together getting saved practically at the same time, the same time frame. We got saved. Amen. The number one priority was church. We didn't miss Tuesday or Friday night. We always went to church. We read Bible study. And we read the Bible until the Bible just made us cry. It was just finger licking good. You know, after how many years have we been married now? 50? Glory. I mean, I don't know how things could be any better. Amen. 55. Y'all figured it out, 55 years. But let me tell you that most of the blessings that we have received has been through helping others. Oh man, that, why do we have children that's never been in jail, never had any running with the laws? All of them are saved, spirit-filled. Never gave us a moment of trouble. And I don't even remember, I mean, I can't even remember whether any of them went to the prom or not. The mama might know. Did Derek, did you go? Well, nothing, I guess, really bad about it, but I just did. Amen. We didn't tell them that you can't do this, you can't do that. We never told them that they had to come to church. Every time we headed out to church, they felt like they were supposed to go. They wanted to go. Amen. Just to see how God has blessed us all these years, our children and our what? Grandchildren. How many know it pays to serve the Lord? It pays to meditate the word of God what? Day and night. How many can say praise the Lord? Day and night. Amen. Hallelujah. I just want to get back to this scripture. Give yourself wholly to read, completely over to reading. No, I was at James. Let me just read that, then I go back to my original. But the wisdom that is from above is first what? Pure. Everybody said pure. Then what? Peaceable. You know, you don't just get like that overnight. I know that when you get saved and spirit-filled and all of that, that you get a clean slate, but there's got to be some mind renewing. And it's going to take some what? Some work to bring yourself to a point where you will be what? Perfectly pleasing to God. All right? It says pure, then peaceable, gentle. How many know it takes a while sometimes if you... Amen, amen. Talking about gentle, easy to be entreated. Amen. A whole lot of us been here a long time ain't easy to be entreated. Ain't gentle easy. Amen. Hallelujah. Full. Everybody say full.
Full.
All right. Say it again. Full.
Full.
Full of mercy. Now, I don't think you got a whole lot of mercy if you don't ever have time. You want to spend all your time watching television, being on the phone, just idling your time away and never have time for anybody else.
And I'm telling you how you can get the answers to your prayers speedily. Amen. You got to deal with people. You got to love people. You got to be concerned about their needs. Okay. Let me go further. Full of mercy and good fruits. Well, I'm dealing with one of them right now. All right. Everybody say, full of mercy. Amen. I think everybody ought to get a partner in this church. And amen. God is going to hold you accountable. Amen. All of the needs that we have right around us, and we can't connect with somebody and do meditations with them. And you got the book. You don't have to make up the meditations. You ain't got to what? Go to the store and buy them. I mean, you already have it. Amen. And we're praying and we're believing God for our healing. Now, y'all know what happened. Y'all heard the story. Sister Hill told you what happened to me about 3 or 4 months ago. And amen. Even out of all that took place, I came out health-wise unscathed. No heart, no brain problem, no stroke, no aneurysm, none of that at all. How many can say amen?
Amen?
And I know a whole lot of people, while we were there, we read about some people that died having the same experience that I had. Amen. But Sister Hill, this is what she said. She said that she remembered the story. Said, I wasn't aware of anything. The last thing I remember, I can't breathe. Amen. But how many believe that you can set up prayers ahead of time? You don't wait till what? The battle is over. You don't wait until what trouble comes. But you can what? You can send prayers. You can pray for things that what? That you don't know anything about in advance. We don't know what we should pray for as we ought. Amen. But the Spirit Himself can make one intercession for us. Amen. And groaners and moaners. How many ever heard me groan and moan and holler out and cry and pray? Amen. Hallelujah. See, that's the thing that will save you in the day of what adversity. The Bible says, blessed is the man that considereth the poor, for in the time of trouble, amen, God will what? God will what? He will remember him. Hallelujah. How many can say praise the Lord? And that was the thing that I believe that spared my life was the words. My wife, she said she went to 2 Kings 20 and she read the story of Hezekiah.
Yeah.
Amen. The story of Hezekiah, remember when the Isaiah came to him and told him that set his house in order, that he was going to what? Die, and he's not going to live. But the Bible says Hezekiah turned his what? Face to the wall, and he began to what? He began to pray. And the Bible says he wept sore. He prayed until he wept sore. I mean, it was an earnest, fervent, heartfelt, serious prayer. The Bible says the effectual and fervent prayer of a righteous man does what? Avail much. And after he prayed and wept sore, the Bible says Isaiah went back and delivered the message that God gave for Hezekiah again. He says that, I have heard thy prayer. I've seen your tears. Isn't that something? I've heard your prayer and I have what? Seen your tears. And I'm going to add what? 15 more years to your life. I'm going to turn things around. And God turned things around for me. Amen. And when I came through after 5 or 6 days, down in 3 days in the hospital, just 2 or 3 days, I came back hitting the ground running. Amen. Nobody can holler as loud as I can. Nobody can praise God no more sincere and fervently as I can. I came back, amen, running for my life.
Hallelujah.
How many can say? At that point, I couldn't even cry out loud because every time I would cry out loud, it seemed like my breath would leave my body. It seemed like I would faint or fall over. Amen. And the devil seemed like he had me just where he was. You can't what? Pray. You can't what? Cry out. You can't what? Delight yourself in the Lord. Amen. Praise God. I knew that the answer was in what? Delighting thyself in the law of the Lord. And the Lord, amen, he will give us what the desires of our heart. You know what I did? I said, Satan, you lie, you lie. I began to agree with God.
Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I agree with God, and I began to confess my healing and my deliverance and my release from captivity.
Yes.
Amen. I began to raise my voice.
Yes.
Bible says the righteous cry of the Lord will hear it.
Yes.
And deliver them out of all of their what? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let me go further. Sister Hill, amen. So I got three things I got to come up with. Hallelujah. I'm still in 1 Timothy 4. All right. Hallelujah. How many can say amen? Hallelujah. 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 Those works are the things that, that's one area. Your works. Hallelujah. The Bible says, be careful to maintain good works. Amen. God said that we are to be zealous of what? Good works. Amen. Your work. That's the thing that saved Hezekiah. He said, Lord, I have what? Walked before you with what? Perfect heart. Did he say that in the 2 Kings? I have what? Done all that you have what? Told me to do. So God saw his works. And the works were the thing that what? Touched the heart of God. That was one of the things. Now the other thing that touched the heart of God was his brokenness. Amen. We'll get to that later. But I want to go back to that scripture in 1 Timothy because I want to you make sure you get that good. 1 Timothy, that was 4:20. All right? Meditate upon these things. This is verse 15. All right, 13. Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. That's instructing others, teaching and instructing others. Verse 15. Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly. W-H-O-L-L-Y. To them, that thy profiting may appear to all. How many can see that if we give ourselves wholly, W-H-O-L-L-Y, to meditation, to the word of God, that our profiting may appear to all? Verse 16, take heed, everybody help me with this, take heed unto what? Thyself. And unto the doctrine, continue in them. For in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them. How many believe that our healing message is working? How many still got your healing meditations? How many can see a change, amen, in your health condition already? Sister Wayne said that the doctor has told her, amen, in 6 months. He's thinking about off the blood pressure. And I can scream as loud as I, all y'all together.
Hallelujah.
And what happened, amen, the results of it is that I have never flowed more freer and seen, amen, and sang more freely in the Holy Ghost than I have in the last 2 or 3 months. Amen. When you let go and let God, when you shout the praise, even though your body said what? Man, you're going to have a stroke. You're gonna burst an artery. I got some warning from some of y'all. You said you better kind of be careful here.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. How many remember the man that amen, that turned around, you know, those 10 lepers that were lifting up their voices from afar off and they were trying to get Jesus' attention and he said, Master, Master, they lifted up their voices.
Yes.
Have mercy on us.
Yes.
And Jesus, what? Told them, go show yourself to the priest. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, as one of those lepers went, amen, he what? When he saw that he was healed, glory, when he saw that he was cleansed, he turned around and with a loud voice, glory, he turned around and what? Glorified God. How many can lift your hands? That's the key. Turn around and what? Glorify. When you see what God has done for you, when you see the promises of God are all yea and amen, when you see that there hasn't failed one word of all good promises, when you know that God will stand behind his word, his covenant he'll never break, neither alter the thing that have gone out of his mouth. Glory, hallelujah. When you think about all of the promises of God, all of them are what? Yea and amen. Is that enough to shout out loud? I decided I'm just going to shout, give God glory for what? For my complete healing. Glory, glory. I can swallow and holler. I'll go back and check my blood pressure and it's still the same place it was when I left. Amen. How I can say praise the Lord. Woo, glory. Have I covered all three yet? Meditation is the first one. The second one is that. Okay, but maintain good works. That's the first one. Okay. Okay. All right. Open your big mouth and shout. Give God praise. Glorify God. Open your mouth and what? Give God glory. God said, amen, praise God. Those that were trying to shut up the people that were crying out, Hosanna, Hosanna, glory to God in the highest. And the multitude came to Jesus and Jesus, these people are insulted. Amen. Tell them to shut up and tone it down. Jesus said, what? If they should hold their what? Pets, the rocks would what? Immediately would cry out. So I believe that. The Lord likes a little crack. I think he likes a little high. It's all about noise in heaven. Read Revelation 5. You see how much noise is in heaven. Millions and millions and millions of the Bible said they were praising God. Hallelujah. And they were saying what? Worthy. Everybody just turn there. Just turn out. Y'all can hit me with this. I'm closing out on this. Revelation 5, I believe it's 17. I mean, can you think of millions and millions of angels shouting, all of them shouting out loud? Somebody said, God ain't deaf. And he ain't nervous either. If he can put up with tens and thousands and millions of angels, all of them screaming out as loud as they can. 5 and 12, is that them? All right, let's read that. What does it say? Say it with a soft voice. See, that's the problem today. Everybody want toned down. They scared of how y'all gonna respond to it. If I open up and squall real loud, everybody might be looking around. What's wrong with Pastor Hill? Boy, I'm telling you, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Bible says, amen. Lift your voice with a voice of what? Triumph. You got to shout it out. Get free from yourself, your unbelief. Hallelujah. What people think. Hallelujah. Those doubts and all of those hindrances, even those demonic forces working, amen, all above you, all around you. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says the kingdom of heaven suffered what? Violence. It's a whole lot of opposing force coming against you, trying to keep you from what? Getting your breakthrough. Yes. Amen. But the Bible says that the kingdom of heaven suffered what? Violence, but the fire. Come on, say it again. But the what?
Violence.
Not the sophisticated. But the violent will what?
Take it
by force. Hallelujah. that God. Okay, now with those angels, what were they praising God with? Come on. Romans 5, with a loud voice. Everybody say a loud voice.
Loud voice.
Amen. All right. What kind of voice, Brother Sammy?
Loud voice.
What kind of voice, Sister Shirley?
Loud.
You see how she sounded that? Loud.
With a loud voice.
See, it takes violence. It takes perseverance. It takes what? Wholehearted. It takes what? Amen. Real getting down to what? The nitty gritty to get God's attention. How many can say hallelujah? The Bible says he's the effectual fervent. See, we're too easy on the devil. Too easy on our flesh. If you want your prayers, amen, to come before the throne, amen, you're going to have to get what? Violent. I got violent, and I'm okay now.
Yes.
I shot most of y'all. And I wouldn't dare to do that 3 or 4 months ago. So I got to be quiet my blood pressure. I don't want it to get up to 200. When it get over 300, boy, you about gone.
Yes.
Check it out, right? Stroke time. Hallelujah. How many know that if you delight yourself in the Lord?
Yes, yes.
It's all right to delight, get excited in the Lord. Is that right? Yeah. I want Sister Hills from trying to brush me out of here. Come on, verse 12. What did those angels, what were they shouting, y'all?
Worthy.
Come on.
Worthy.
Amen. They weren't sounding like that. Worthy is the Lamb. Come on, act like an angel. Okay, come on, say a little bit more. Worthy is the Lamb that was what? Worthy to receive what? Say it again, loud as you can. Worthy to receive what? Power. Worthy to receive what?
Power.
What else?
Riches.
Everybody say riches. This time, from the very first word, say it.
Say it. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing.
Come on, lift your voice and praise the Lord. Sometimes we don't use
our prayer language. Come on, lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice. In the spirit now, in the spirit. Praise him in the spirit, everybody. Just praise him in the spirit. Everybody, just praise him. Do it with a loud voice. Praise him in the Holy Ghost. Everybody, just praise him in the Holy Ghost. This is the answer. Oh, you got to get beyond. Come on, lift your voice. Raise it up. Tone it up. Come on, lift your heart. Lift karabahoroba. The key, praying with all your heart. Hallelujah. Crown out to God in the Holy Ghost. In your heart of prayer language. Come on, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory, 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 glory. Give him praise, give him praise, give him praise, give him praise for the promised blessing. Give him praise for the promised blessing. Give him praise for his word. Hallelujah, his word doesn't return void. His word accomplished that which it has intended to accomplish. It will prosper in the thing whereunto it is sent. Give it light and give it understanding to the simple. Oh God, the righteous cry and the Lord heareth them and delivereth them out of all of their distresses. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Hey, many of the afflictions of the righteous, but God delivers them out of all of them. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you the glory in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we thank you today for the victory. For this is the victory that overcometh. Even our faith. Hallelujah. Lord, we set on the promises of God. All of the promises in you are yea and amen. We give you praise and glory right now. I'm about to do something that I haven't ever done before. I want every person that will commit, amen, to become zealous of good works by reaching out to your sister or brother with meditations. Amen. Get in, amen. Speaking the word back and forward to each other by phone or in person, those that will make their commitment. Because I don't see no breakthrough unless we obey the word of God. Hallelujah. We're his workmanship created unto what? Good works where God foreordained that we should what? Walk in them. Hallelujah. Word, a love is not in what? Word is in what? Deed and in truth. I want everybody that will make that commitment. You're going to get with somebody. Let somebody get with you. But you're going to involve yourself in building up someone through meditations from the area of healing. Amen. I just want you to raise your hand. Amen. Those that will make that commitment. Hallelujah. 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 All right, that's the first area. Those that will make the commitment of doing the lessons that we have given out in the blue book. I want you to raise your hand. Amen. Now, you've had it for about 3 months. How much longer? Those that will make a commitment to get them in within the next week or two, raise your hand. So I'm looking out for your souls because breakthrough comes from an effort. You have to make a commitment. Hallelujah. A commitment to the word. All right, now, the third thing, commitment to praising, like going up another level in terms of your praise and your worship. Start lifting your voice. Let the voice of your praise be what? Heard.
Let the voice of your what? Praise. No, it's time out. Jesus is soon to come. And your president might hasten the time that Jesus is to come. And I think that we got to make every moment count. How many can say amen? God wants fervency. That's the only thing that prevails in heaven. Is what? Fervency. And let's make a commitment. We're going to what? Tone it up. We're going to what? Pray with brokenness. We're going to say what? Amen. We're going to pour out our hearts to God. Hallelujah. Put your hands up if you can make that commitment. I'm going to change the way I pray. Say that again. I'm going to change. Hallelujah. 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 Now, if you make those three commitments, I want you to lift your hands and say, Lord, I'm making this commitment to you. I'm going to do the Bible says in obedience, because you're supposed to obey them that what have rule over you, that care for your soul. You don't know how many nights I spent crying, and it really saddens my heart, because I know who has done those lessons and I know who hasn't done them. And I know that we won't be able to get beyond that command, obey them that have what rule over you. We need help real bad. We don't realize how close we are to eternity. And what we must do it what? Quickly. And I'm thinking about setting another time for another fast, because I think that we're living in a real serious hour. But lift your hands right now. Father, I make these commitments before you. I'm going to begin to pray as fervent as I can. I'm going to attend prayer as often as I can. And when I come to prayer, I'm going to pour out my heart. I'm going to pour out my soul. And I'm going to praise you with all that I have. And I'm going to spend night and day meditating in your word, and sharing the word, and reciting the word to someone else other than to myself. Father, I plan to maintain good works. And I give you praise and glory right now. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. All right, we just want you to take notes of those things, those three things, and we're going to let you go. God bless you. Hallelujah. And we will, this evening at 4, tomorrow evening at 7, and Wednesday night, we will be looking for you that have dropped out. Amen. In Bible study. Father, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest and abide with us. We give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. We thank God for those that come on Tuesday morning. We have a few women coming now on Tuesday morning. And we have a dedicated group that comes on Tuesday. We have some that stay for Bible study from 6 to 7 on Tuesday. Amen. God bless you. God go with you.